Hi everyone, so this is going to be the SGT OET writing on why to refer is not the purpose of your OET letter. I want to explain in depth why that is, and I'm not just going to base it on what I know, I'm going to base it on what is being said in the OET assessment criteria and double descriptors from the occupationalenglishtest.org dated 26 Feb 2019. All right, so let's start with a misconception though. There is an understanding for most students that there are three main purposes. They say that it would be to refer, because it's a referral letter. The other one is to transfer, since it's a transfer letter. And the next one is to discharge, because it's supposedly a discharge letter. I'm here to debunk this myth and this highly inaccurate and if not misleading way of thinking in OET writing. Now, why is it wrong? If you look at the writing assessment criteria and level descriptors, it says here that the purpose criteria for you to get the full score there, the purpose of a document is immediately apparent and sufficiently expanded as required. This just means that the purpose should be in the introduction. But it doesn't really tell us what the purpose is until we go to the level descriptors. It says here for the criterion of purpose, the definition they have of purpose is that it should help the reader, the receiver, it should help the person you are writing to get a quick and precise sense of what is asked of them. So I'm going to copy paste this definition by the occupationalenglishtest.org, and we're going to paste that here and see if it matches or if it makes sense if we're going to use the following to refer to transfer as a definition for purpose. Okay, so if I'm going to say the purpose of this letter is to refer whatever patient, then we have to ask ourselves, will this line give or help the reader get a quick sense, quick and precise sense of what is asked of him or her? And the answer is no. Instead, the receiver will ask, why are you referring the patient to me? What do I have to do? What do you need from me? What are you asking me to do? And when you look at it that way, this supposed purpose of this is to refer doesn't really help the receiver get a quick sense of what he or she needs to do. So that's why I keep telling students, please don't write this as the purpose. I mean, you can mention it, but please do not have that misconception that that is the purpose the criteria is asking for. You'll get a penalty. You will not get a good grade. In fact, you'll get zero for the purpose criteria because you haven't given the reader a quick and precise sense of what you want them to do, what you're asking them to do. Next, to transfer. It's the same here. If you're going to write, the purpose of this letter is to transfer the patient, that question from the receiver will come up again. The receiver will ask, why are you transferring the patient to me? What do you want us to do with the patient after transfer? So that's what will keep happening whenever you use these types of purpose. It doesn't really give the reader a quick and precise sense of what is asked of him or her. And for me, the worst is to discharge, because if you state that the purpose of this letter is to discharge the patient, then all I can say is congratulations, by all means, discharge the patient. I don't think I need to do anything. So congrats to the patient. I guess I don't need to do anything. That's what they'll think, because, you know, what are you asking the receiver or the reader to do here? Nothing. You're just discharging a patient, and the receiver has zero contribution. The receiver has zero involvement. in the action of discharging the patient. I mean, that's your hospital. That's you as the writer. You're the one who will discharge the patient, not the receiver. So now that brings up the question, what is a proper purpose then? And it goes back to this definition that we again read from the level descriptor. It has to be something that tells the receiver what is asked of him or her. Let's look at this writing task and see what the purpose would be. So take note that it says here that we are going to write a referral letter to Dr. Jane Thompson. So immediately students will think, oh, it's a referral letter. So the purpose is A, to refer, right? But remember, we're looking for what we want the receiver to do quickly and succinctly. So let's read on. We're going to write a referral letter to Dr. Jane Thompson, and you might ask, why? Why a referral letter? And it says here, to request a review of your patient and to discuss contraceptive options and further testing for sexually transmitted infections and bloodborne viruses. I'm going to copy paste that too. And there we have it. Now we have two options. Is the purpose of your letter A, to refer the patient, or B, to request a review of your patient to discuss contraceptive options and further testing for sexually transmitted infections and bloodborne viruses? I think it's pretty obvious when you look at it, and even of just the length and the how specific it is. The one that helps the reader get a quick and precise sense of what is asked of them is definitely letter B. It is not letter A. It is not to refer. In fact, you could get away with not even mentioning the word refer in the entire letter and still get a perfect score in purpose because you have given the reader a quick and precise sense of what is asked of them. So I hope it's clear. Oh, I see refer. That's the purpose. No, not at all. That is not the purpose, not even close. The purpose is what you want the receiver or the reader to do. Here's another sample. In this one, it says that we're going to write a transfer letter. So, okay, with that, the student might think, the purpose is to transfer. But once again, you have to ask yourself, does to transfer give the receiver an idea of what he or she needs to do? In this case, the social worker. Now, it says here that we're going to be describing relevant hospital details to provide support towards the patient and her family for a transition to aged care. And that's the other option we can go with. Which one gives the receiver or reader a clear and precise or short sense of what he or she needs to do? Is it A, the purpose is to transfer this patient? Or B, the purpose is for you to provide support towards the patient and her family for a transition to aged care? And once again, I think it's pretty obvious that the answer is this. This is the true purpose. This is what we really want to write in our introduction. You could even do it word for word. In fact, I would suggest you write this word for word instead of saying, the purpose of his letter is to refer. The purpose of his letter is to transfer. And worse yet, I mentioned this a while ago, saying that the purpose of his letter is to discharge a patient. I mean, here you could see that you're a charge nurse at a hospital where Goldstein was admitted, and using the information, you're to write a discharge letter. And again, students will immediately jump on that thinking, oh, that means the purpose is A, to discharge. Once again, no, that is not the purpose. It doesn't give the receiver or the reader a quick and precise sense of what you're asking of him to do. It says here, though, that the reason you are writing the discharge letter is for discharge back into permanent full-time care. So, what is the purpose? Is it to discharge the patient or to request permanent full-time care? And that's really how simple it really is. When you're reading the writing task, please don't just look at, oh, I see the keyword refer. Oh, I see the keyword transfer. Oh, I see the keyword discharge. That's not the purpose, guys. No one cares. The receiver does not care about that. What the receiver cares about is, what do you want me to do? What do you need from me? What are you asking of me? And this is what is doing that. It's to request permanent full-time care. It's to provide support towards the patient and her family for transition to aged care. It's to request for a review of the patient and discuss contraceptive options and further testing. That's the purpose. I hope it's 100% clear. I hope you'll never write again. The purpose is to refer, the purpose is to transfer, or the purpose is to discharge. Again, give the reader a precise sense of what you're asking from them. So that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you so much for your time. And if you want more information or to learn more, enroll in SGT now. Thank you for your time and good luck with your review.